Well, what a game we have in store. I think we're both very excited for this one, to put it bluntly.
Yeah, absolutely. First game of the day for us, and we couldn't have asked for a better matchup. Team Dignitas versus Ninjas in Pyjamas. An interesting map. I don't think we've actually casted a cash game this whole tournament, so this would be a nice little change for us.
No, cash is, you know, one of those maps. It's actually a really great map to have in the pool, but it's seen so infrequently. And doing some research for this game, trying to find out, you know, NIP's history on cash, because we were talking before, it's thinking, NIP on cash, this could be really bad.
Yeah.
It's hard to find results for NIP on cash. They did beat Complexity SEA on cash 16-7.
Mm-hmm.
If you go back a year, you'll find a defeat against Astana Dragons 12-6.
Good research, it's deep.
They beat Na'Vi at Star Series 16-12 on this match, and they lost to LGB, or XLGB, and Face It on it 13-16. Not a lot of match history on it. Last time these two sides faced off was in Face It, and Dignitas did beat NIP by 16-12, but that was on Inferno. Pretty tough to call, but my gut feeling says this was the worst map choice NIP could have had.
Absolutely. I think it's all going to come down to the knife round here. If we can see Team Dignitas take CT first, I think they're going to park the bus like they normally do. They're such a CT. It looks like they are. They've got CT here. I think it's exactly what they wanted. They'll be looking to kind of lock this out completely. I think NIP are going to find this very difficult indeed to penetrate the Dignitas defenses. They'll definitely be looking to get the pistol here. They know they need to get some momentum built if they're going to have any chance. Last time I casted NIP on this map, it looked like they were almost lost in it. They don't have a very tactical approach to it. They kind of stick to their methodology of kind of sticking together and using their chemistry to get rounds. But let's see how it's going to jump into this now and see how it unfolds.
Yes, as you're stuck looking at us, we'd rather look at the game. There we go. And we will spy Forrest on board first. Zipnix is the man who's going to be waiting for them. And, you know, it was a point that Thorin made yesterday that couldn't agree more with. Dignitas are just built for CT side. Oh, they love to defend. And we'll see whether that is a virtue that will hold them true, as Zipnix will find himself the first shot. Does a fair bit of damage. Device is going to help him out to the frag of Freiburg. Get Right comes in. Forrest as well in frags, but Dignitas have two more as Fifth Laren exists. And then Get Right go down. It's all on Forrest. 1-on-3. And he will get picked off by Dupree. And Dignitas find themselves a pistol round to the good.
Yeah, that's exactly the start Dignitas wanted. They wanted to get a huge campaign built here. And NIP kind of not doing anything too impressive. I think they were just relying on the Glock, kind of like I said before, kind of they kind of group up and kind of take things together, and they rely on their individual skill on this map, I think. This is the perfect start for Team Dignitas. They're going to be wanting to not drop any frags. They want to build up their economy and kind of keep these rifles. We can see Fetish actually opted just to use a CZ here. Bought a rifle, kind of interesting, suggest he might be awful.
Here you go. Could be Get Right to get one frag, but helped by Exist, they get a second, in fact, and they should get a bit of an entry in towards that site. Fiflara can see the bomb downed on the site. They have two men left up against the three, and we'll see whether they can collect themselves any weapons. That'll be a goal that is quickly struck down as Fiflara is picked off, and now it's Get Right who does have that Famas. 1-on-3 with a minute left to go, and the bomb just waiting to be grabbed as he sits in wait for Dupree to show himself as he collects that one. And this is going to be a bonus for him here. They hear it going down and they will chase him out. There's the first, and Get Right won't get over that first hurdle. It'll be Device who picks him off, but bomb plant for an IP.
I don't think Dignitas should have allowed that. I think they should have. I know they're trying to be passive and they'll not give away any frags, but the fact they've allowed the bomb to go down in that situation means the AKs will be coming out this round, and this allowed NIP to get back into this round. We saw a couple of frags being dropped at Dignitas as well, so, but as I say that, we can see a very interesting development on the left-hand side of the screen there.
Yeah, remember, we can only say so much. The teams can occasionally hear a whisker from us, and so we'll have to be somewhat vague for you. But interesting stuff here. You know, there is, well, we'll come on to kind of the experience level on these two sides in just a second, as Fetish will fulfill your prediction. And we'll see Hazy getting himself further and further acquainted with what is no longer new surroundings, but AZ has really grown into that role in Dignitas.
Fantastic player, one of the real hot talents in Europe right now.
And, he and his FAMAS will be in action. Fetish hasn't rattled off a shot yet. And with Fifth Laren already down, this is a Big decision. Dupree's the man who's coming in as well. And that's, you feel that Dupree is offering a lot of information there. Device is pushed down as well, so they know where NIP are. And Freiburg gets himself the first. But the roll of that Molotov forces Fetish out of position. And they get themselves a frag and two and three. The older AWP unable to get involved. And now it's Zipnix to try and save onto that site with Device to his right-hand side doing the damage as well. Get right one on two to try and save this round for NIP. It was going oh so well for him until he lost everyone as they ran up towards that site. And now Get Right feeling a tad lonely as he will be flashed, but he's wise to that and is going to have to start to look at that clock as he goes for it. Zipnix had moved and Get Right was unable to take out the three positions he had to look at. He looked at the one where there wasn't a player.
Well, those are quite interesting. I think Nip can take a lot away from that round. They're kind of, from what I said before, they didn't really rely so much on the tactics of the map, but they seemed to execute that strat really well. It was unfortunate they didn't pick up as many kills as they would have liked there, but I think it was a good sign that he can get into the B-bomb site, and I think they'll be looking to execute that again. Possibly they can use that strategy again for maybe a little fake of that, and kind of, I think it'll be interesting to see how that pans out.
So, eco round for NIP. I mean, yesterday was underwhelming for the Swedish side.
Definitely, like they really, really let themselves down, I think. But today everything resets, they're in the bracket and it doesn't really matter. Today is a new day. You've got to beat everyone in the tournament to win, so it doesn't really matter who you get in this stage of the tournament, to be honest.
Talking with Heaton before the game, I said to you, what is the insight? What did you say to those players? And he said, well, this is just like DreamHack Summer last year. We had a terrible opening day, and then we came back and we stormed them. And it was some of these Danes that they stormed on their way to victory.
Well, so that's either the world's best team right now. They can come back from when they're faced with adversity. They can get back into it, and they, that's why they're such a strong team right now.
That eco amounting to little. And it'll be a four-round advantage for Team Dignitas, who, though a Danish lineup, as we Brits look to claw on to any sense of pride, are a proud British organization led by Odie, their British bulldog of an owner.
Oh, yes.
And he will tell you that it would mean a lot to him to win on home soil. He's got a big roster of players here across all the tournaments. NIP on a buy round this time out. And a great toss from that Molotov there. If there was someone up there, it would have been perfect. But there wasn't. They will find Dupree, though, just seconds after he dispatches of Exist. And Forest's position is a little isolated up here. Once you're there, and they know you're there, you're stuck. You can either jump down into the pit or not. As that device will sit waiting. This is a map that actually, you see MBK always go for the SSG on. He loves it.
Yes. So it's a not viable weapon, in my opinion, but you definitely see it popping up every now and then. I guess in this kind of map, it does almost make sense at high angles.
Forrest will leave Freiburg out there to roast as Fifth Larry gets himself the frag onto Zipnix. It's 3-on-2 in favor of Dignitas here, and that will be closed out by Fetish and Device. NIP haven't gotten going, and despite some rounds with some positivity, that doesn't reflect on the scoreboard.
The main thing about Cash Right is the mid area. If you can't break through the middle defenses, you're not going to win rounds. It's all about that. That's why you see Dignitas at the start of the round. They're sending three people there and kind of locking it down. It's almost a gamble because you're kind of sending one person to each bombsite at that point, and you kind of, it's all about rotation. That's why Fetish is such a good in-game leader, because he's able to read the game so well and call where his teammates need to be and kind of send the forces where they need to be. But it's working perfectly for right now. 5-0, and this is what we're talking about, them being such a strong CT side.
5-0, just one bomb plant in those rounds as well. There are no really close rounds.
Not really. Like, they get the bomb down, but their seams of the clutches really aren't going their way. And Fetish picked up a huge frag on Fifth Laren there, and that's going to probably lock the round out for the terrorists yet again.
NIP just looking for an opening. They just want one frag, and that will maybe open up a site for them. But as you say, that AZ has found two NIP players, and well, with the help of Zipnix, dispatch of them. Great play from AZ. Get Right joins Forrest in the grave as it'll be just Exist left 1-on-5. And, you know, traditionally a caster might turn to you and say, well, what would you do differently at this stage?
But to be honest, like, they're not doing anything too tactical. They're kind of just staying as a group of five and kind of walking into the bomb sites, getting picked off one by one, and it's kind of leading them with not a whole lot to do. I think they need to kind of maybe turn things a bit faster, to kind of just back to basics, really. If you can just smoke off that mid connector towards CT spawn and send your swarm of T's out after the CT smokes have run out, just something basic like that, kind of you're going to stay together and use those tactics. Just kind of speed it up a little bit more instead of just walking into positions and finding yourself meeting orbs like they have been so far. Fifth Lion got picked off very easily there, and I think that kind of set the tone for the round already. 6-0 here, and it looks like the money situation is still not going to be great in NIP, and it's going to be possibly a seventh round going in favor of Dignitas here. But yeah, it's looking fantastic for them. Dignitas don't need to change anything right now. They're kind of they're locking down all areas in the map, and it just seems like NIP are kind of just poking around, seeing if there's any sort of weaknesses anywhere. But the rotations are so strong from Dignitas right now, but I'm not sure what they can do in this situation to kind of get back into this.
Six rounds in, NIP have a whopping 9 frags on the scoreboard.
Oh, wow.
Fetish with an awesome hit onto Get Right. You can only enjoy that. Zipnix follows up with one more onto Forest, and the Dignitas side are really beginning to enjoy it. But the moment you say that, Exist and Freiburg both get themselves a kill, and that only angers the Danes, and Zipnix gets the next one, and it'll be Exist again. 1-on-3 has a weapon, but 1-on-3 nevertheless, and a lonely Swede in a very Danish area.
What's good to know on this as well, you see Fetish kind of changing his position almost every single round. So one round, he's in middle of the orb, and then he just faced towards that the A alley, getting the first pick of the round, and that's what's winning them rounds. As soon as you take out that first terrorist, whatever tactic they had in mind and what they were planning on executing, that completely goes out the window. Whoever's in the set strategy at that point gets taken out, and they kind of have to kind of recalculate what they're going to do, and that's what's losing them rounds on now, those early picks. So NIP need to maybe either go a lot faster or slow it down and allow them to kind of isolate the AWPers before executing their strategy.
You see that smoke does force Fetish to move out. There's a second one there, double flash, and Fetish finds himself. This was what you suggested they did to force an isolation, and it's worked perfectly. Freiburg gets himself the frag onto AZ, and now Fetish will see action, and he misses his opening shot, goes down to 12 points of health, and NIP have a real opening here onto that B site, as they're going to have to go for a four-man retake with a device on low health, Fetish on low health. It's unlikely they'll be able to pull this off, but they'll want to make this as expensive as possible for a side that have lost 7 in a row.
Yeah.
And that just isn't going to happen, as Forrest shows exactly what he is capable of. And Zipnix is one man that will see if there is a back of a head that he can shoot at.
I think any kill he can find right now will be a consolation. Like you said, if he can just take some money off the NIP side, who are obviously struggling in there. Economic department right now, that'd be great for them. But yeah, interesting to note on that. So they smoked off the AWPer there, they knew where he was going to be, got out in middle, kind of split the B bomb site, and then that's what works so well. You don't need to do anything too fancy in this map. I know a lot of people like to use the Molotovs and kind of make everything, and I think it makes everything a bit too obvious. You need to kind of smoke off the choke points and just get out there and start fragging, and that's what they did, and they need to do more of that now. Obviously, rounds are dwindling away here. They've got 6 left, so let's take it up again and get some rounds on the board.
NIP win their first round here in the quarterfinal. Remember, best of 3. Now, next map will be Inferno with Dust if we need it.
Yes.
And last time these two teams met on Inferno, it was Dignitas who won it.
Another CT bias map, so I think that'll be another knife-dependent outcome, maybe.
Device picks himself up the frag onto Freiburg, and for NIP, it was perhaps not the beginning of a new dawn for them. They do get 2 kills in this round, but they're down 1, and it's Get Right and Exist to try and do something. Exist is now the last man standing. He's been downed as Dignitas reclaim the lead and winning 1 out of 7 and then losing the next.
Yep, devastating. But to be fair, like I think they lost so many in a row that it's not going to be too much of a big deal. Looking at their bankroll right now, it doesn't seem too bad. I think they should be able to comfortably buy here.
Get Right in an interesting role in this round. See whether that can mix it up. It is the Henry G plan B.
Yes, that's it. If all else fails, try give this a go and see what you can do.
Yeah, we'll see what Get Right can do with it.
There it is. Lovely stuff in there.
Picks off Fetish, who had no expectation of seeing an AWP coming around that corner.
Exactly. That's
so it was
why
in
it's
a
good.
Bit of an obvious position when you just don't think someone's coming. And let's see what they can do. They've lost Forest, though, NIP, to the hands of Dupree. Fifth Laren will. And Dupree has been a real stalwart for Dignitas in this tournament over the past 3 to 6 months. He just is growing with this team as Fifth Flowering gets himself the frag onto AZ. Device returns the favor. And with 3-on-3. Yep, ready to make their entry as the nades launch on in towards that A site. And Zipnix knows that he's going to be seeing action. The ex-Fnatic man sits and waits and firing through the flash, gets himself a headbog onto Freiburg, and now we'll go for the next man. It's Exist, and he's like, well, one by one, why not? Yeah. And Getright, unable to offer much support with that AWP, is now alone!
Oh, God.
And Dupree adds insult to injury. With a knife in the back.
This looks a little bit too easy for Dignitas right now. If you saw Zipnix there, kind of the frags he was given to him on a play, the players just come out one by one, like you said, and there was no real...
No pressure,
no flashbangs. He was kind of just there, kind of one frag, here's another, and then we even saw an opportunity for Getright to get knifed there. I think that is a sign of how unprepared maybe in pajamas are on this map. They seem a little bit lost right now. If they're going to get back into this, I have to say they need all the rounds remaining.
Now, the one difference between these two sides, aside from the 8 rounds, is Dignitas aren't experienced in turning these situations around.
Yeah.
NIP live for moments like this. They don't like easy tournaments.
They like to make it hard for themselves, that's for sure. And the masters are getting back into it. So at this point, like, I'd like to say, oh, this game's over. But when you're playing against NIP, you just never know what they've got up their sleeve. So it looks like this eco round will be going in the favor of Dignitas. Dupree picking up a couple of kills there. Great stuff from him. And Device cleaning up as well. It's going to leave a 5-on-2 situation in favor of Dignitas.
This is going to be 10-1 Dig with the conversion of this round. And this is a time when, you know, what was interesting to observe yesterday was, you know, we talked about the role of the manager being, you know, largely a cheerleader, with the exception of someone like Devilwalk. And Heaton himself has been muted. You know, there's not been that, you know, screaming, you know, bicep ripping man behind them, you know, scaring them into winning.
I think that comes more when it's a really close game against the top team and you can feel rounds going backwards and forwards and huge big plays, like huge clutches and stuff. That's when you can get that adrenaline play out. But when games like this, where your team's getting battered in this situation, it's hard to get that hype and that energy into the game.
Here we go, charging forward. Dupree will get himself one under Forest, but then goes down at the hands of Freiburg. And that's probably a trade that Dignitas would be happy for, get Forest out, because Forest is in this tournament has been the clutch player for NIP.
Oh, yes.
As Fiflaren puts the Swede a man to the good. And it'll be Zipnix who will see action here as he's flashed out, but then goes for the first, and we're going tit for tat, frag for frag. Hazy, who will sit in deep on that site, has two players ready to come, and he'll drop the first. It's Exist that goes down, and now all rests on Fiflaren's shoulders. Can he get over the first hurdle? He's shown his position, and he will have another man chasing him out very, very shortly. But having we won't say that, as he will make his way through. He will be spotted by Fetish, and Fiflaren, a master of these situations, will spin back around. Just enough to drop AZ and makes this a real round for NIP. Gets that big frag, drops it down to a 1v1. The clock beginning to tick at 21 seconds on the board. Fiflaren with it all to play for as NIP look to salvage a round on this round as that most veteran of Swedes will put the bomb down. And it is Fetish versus Fiflaren. And Fiflaren strikes first as Fetish goes down to 40 points of health. Fetish now going to get the finish off on him. Can you believe it? Fiflaren almost able to turn that around on his own, but Fetish just able to do enough.
Yeah, such smart play there from Fiflaren. I feel really bad for him. He wasn't able to bring home the bacon on that one. His movement was really good. Great work to get that early pick on the two-on-one situation. He got the bomb down. It looked like after he got that first initial damage on the Fetish, though, he was going to kind of take that round and make it this side a bit less devastating for NIP. But yeah, I'm very unlucky for him, but can't take anything from Fetish there. That's another big round for them, and it's going to take the scoreline to 11-1, and this looks like it might be almost over for Ninjas in Pyjamas.
Well, what a first half for Dignitas. When they woke up this morning, they would have been dreaming of a scenario like this.
They wouldn't. Fantastic stuff for them.
But this isn't an 11-1 where you can turn around and say there have been many rounds that Nip deserved to win. Maybe that was the only one, despite the round that they won, that you can say, actually, that one could have gone either way.
Yeah, and that's just down to a big performance from Fifth Laren there. Like, he did, he put his all into that to try and get them back into that round, but unfortunately it wasn't enough. We're going to see a more slow play from Nip here. It looks like they're almost a bit too stifled to get into the bombsite right now. They're just kind of holding quite tentatively to see what they can do to get back into this bombsite.
Is Getright, who'll rattle off a few shots and escape relatively unscathed. Dignitas will be licking their lips. They'll feel that the number one team in the game are there for the taking. There is a scalp to be had here.
Huge scalp.
Nazy goes down, courtesy of Forrest there. Awesome work from him with the Molotov. As now the next shot will come in from Fetish, who misses out. Fifth Laren and then gets himself one back onto Dupree. We're at a 5-on-3, but low health across the ninjas as they get the next frag. It's Fetish that's downed and out. And now Device versus 5 with the help of Zipnix will almost have the better of Forrest. Not to be. And they'll wait for Device now. They know exactly where he's going to show himself from. But what about Zipnix? Where is he? That's exactly where he is, as he will be the one to lead the assault. For Dignitas' perspective, they're going to try exactly as they did in the last situation and say, if we can get exit frags, great. Yes. If we can't, doesn't really matter.
I think that round really just came down to that one AWP shot from Fetish. You saw him like that as that crosser went into the locker room there. Missed quite a reasonably easy shot, in my opinion, got his teammate killed in that area. I think had he have hit that shot, that round could have been a very different outcome. But, Ninjas and Pajamas getting themselves a second round on the board. They really do need the remaining two rounds here. They're going to have any chance of getting back into this. I don't see their CT being as strong as Dignitas is here, so they definitely need these last two rounds.
Look at that half from Dupree. We were complimenting AZ at the start of the half, but really it's Dupree. 17 kills for just 5 deaths. He's had his Weetabix. It'll be Freiburg to open up the fragging this round for NIP. Fetish goes down, and when that AWP has been isolated or killed, even better for NIP, then the nice rounds have been opened. Dupree just goes looking and finds himself a Freiburg as now AZ pushes in. The Dignitas side are ready to go. Get right again, wielding the plan B. As Device just went looking. Didn't see half the bodies that were out there, though. But we'll have heard enough to say, yeah, might want to be worried about that. And we'll be chased out here. And oh, you would have put your money on Fifth Laren getting the better of that one. Forrest did get one before AZ avenged with a kill. But Getright comes in onto Dupree. And NIP are 2-on-2. In fact, I thought they were a man to the good. It's 2-on-2 here as AZ and Zipnix take on Getright and Exist. As Getright will escort Exist.
And Nip really seems to be favouring that B bombsite right now. Seems to be getting the frags there, and I think they've only just realised that at this stage in the game, and it might be a little bit too late right now.
Well, there is Zipnix ready to stop that push, and with only 14 seconds left to go, they should be able to get in there, but Zipnix is no slouch as he moves in and gets a kill onto Exist, but the damage was done. Oh, Zipnix gets both, and that will be Dignitas taking up round number 12, and this is exceptional play.
Yeah, this is exactly last time I casted Nip on cash. This is exactly the thing I saw. They're like on T side, I think they look a little bit lost. I think if they had started CT, they could have got some rounds on the board and kind of relied on their individual play. But right now, it just seems like they're relying on Getright to get the AWP. He's obviously not their main AWP. We know he's very handy with one, but on most maps, we'll obviously see Fifth Laren or Forrest wielding the AWP. So you kind of get that impression. They kind of have a lack of ideas when it comes to this map. We see that BXQ coming in a few times in the now, but they're just not winning the rounds. They get the first few entry kills, but it's just like they haven't got enough to work with.
Saw a shot of the crown here. Bigger crowd for CSGO today. We welcome you to the stage, and thank you for joining us here on the PC Master Race side of the tournament. Definitely a few COD converts. They're like, oh, wow. A mouse. Skill with a mouse. I like it.
Good game.
Yeah. NIP just, they're going to want to get off this map ASAP. Forrest with a hell of a hit onto Fetish there. And now we'll push in, follows up with a second, but on the other side of the map, Zipnik's just going to town on Freiburg and Getright. Piflarin eventually stops the rot, but that's four frags in two rounds for Zipnik as the bomb gets planted and we're a two-on-two after plant. Dupree, the man of the map thus far, is still alive and ready to go. It's Exist who shows a lot to him, and that's why, because he wanted his head. And AZ will go alone and nice lose out to Exist, who does the damage there. Two frags for him, saving the plant, and that will be 12-3 at halftime.
Yep, I've got to say, I don't think that's enough for NiP. I think they'll definitely get back into the game. I don't think it's going to be a complete whitewash. I see them probably getting the pistol here. They'll do what they can do. They'll probably have to do something a little bit audacious to guarantee that for them, but I think they'll get at least seven or eight, but I think it's just going to be delaying the inevitable here. I think Dignitas will be able to find their footing on this map and kind of just take home those four rounds they need.
And you know what's interesting is Dignitas is such solid performance that they've had in this tournament has really been on the background of murmurings of discontent.
Yeah.
That, you know, they did take a break going into this. They've only had a week's warm-up. And, you know, the phrase of take a break was more like me telling Henry, you know, I need my space. We should take a break. You know, that was the undertone of this tournament, that Dignitas could underperform in a big way, and that has not been the case at all.
Well, I think that's true. Like, if you could, sometimes you can overplay and kind of get yourself into like a rut and burn yourself out. Sometimes a break is good. Kind of come back with a bit more refreshing attitude and kind of a different mentality almost. I think we've seen that from Dignitas. It's such a strong tournament so far. It's been fantastic to watch them play, and they are my tip to win this so far.
And socially, they look very strong together. They look like they
enjoy.
Proper
unit, aren't they? Yeah.
Anyway, it'll be. Easy to pick himself up a headshot onto Piflarin. Dupree had a just exceptional tournament today as AZ comes in and Fetish is there. And NIP, well, they're going to need something of biblical proportions to turn this one around. It's Forest who, I'm pretty sure if you look at page 212, is written into the Bible somewhere. But we're asking a lot from him, particularly with Device lurking. Oh, and maybe missed his opportunity there, but doesn't matter. He's pulled those two CTs out, and Dupree does go through, and Forrest will be picked off.
I think we'll probably see the armor buy in CZs here from NiP. I think that's they don't want to chuck away any more rounds here. Or will they be going for that next round? It looks like I don't want to give away too much, but they won't be doing that this round. But oh no, hello, there it is.
Called it too early.
Well, there we go. I think, like we said, NiP really do need to do. They don't want to give any more away on rounds. This is already kind of too deep for them to get back into. So we wanted to win this one, doing everything they can to get back into it. As long as Dignitas play a nice, safe game here, keep the range nice and long, they shouldn't have a problem this map. It's not like Inferno or Dust 2 where there's loads of little angles and cubby holes. As long as you smoke off the choke points and go as a unit, you shouldn't really be giving away anti-eco rounds. I think a team like Dignitas as well, they're so regimented. I don't think this will be a problem. I think like, the way they're approaching this right now seems almost perfect. Got someone covering the flanks. Kind of you see that formation they're kind of opting for in the middle.
On board with NIP, who stick together on what's the easier position to be in when with the weapons they've got against the opponents they've got.
Sure.
And will pick themselves up frag number one. It's Forrest who gets it. Dupree downed. And Dignitas have played into NIP's defense where they've stacked those men. But the question is, will that actually count for anything? Freiburg does get the second frag. Getright gets the third. NIP with a fighting chance, 2-on-2. But coming fighting is Zipniks and AZ as they get themselves that next frag. And the further away Freiburg gets, the less likely he is to be able to reclaim this. He wants a gun. He gets the gun. And
he fancies it.
He's going to have to go for it with his Galil. We'll go all the way down to the wire. Freiburg jumps up, looks for the first man. Oh, and AZ spots him first. And Freiburg was ready to deliver something big, but it wasn't to be. It is 14-3, Dignitas.
Yeah, I think this is going to be looking at match point here. They really can't afford to do another one of those CZ armor buys. I think they'll just be looking to forget this map as quickly as possible. I think we all know the outcome of this right now. This is going to take Dignitas to match point, and unless NiP have got something extraordinary in the bag, I don't see them getting back into it whatsoever. We can see another full eco from here. This should, of all things, as a plan, Dignitas take them to match point here. Or map point, as I should say.
Yeah. The producer who's got those little zeros underneath the two names today, he's been like, yes, I finally get to drop these zeros into ones.
They mean something today. Yeah. Excellent.
Easy picks himself up the frag. Exist is joining Forest Downed and Fetish with a happy frag to that one. Dignitas now will move in and
there it is.
Wash out that last man. And here we go. 12 map points for Team Dignitas. This has been is about complete a map victory as you could ask for.
Well, this is what I called at the start of the game. As soon as you see Dignitas on that CT side on a map like Cached, so such a tactically heavy map, I think you just knew this result was coming. I think we've got Inferno and Dust2 next, but that's when we'll see Nip come into their own. But for me, this is over.
Dare I say this has been assisted suicide for
NIP?
Oh,
nice. I think we all know where you're going with that. Oh, excellent work.
Straight to hell is where I'm going with that one. Can't buy jokes like that, kids. Here we go. It's Fifflower and gets himself the frag onto Dignitas, but Dupree quickly comes back in on him. NIP have two men to the good here as Forest has decided to perk up with frags, and now it's AZ and Fetish who will have to do something about it, but Freiburg shooting into the mech, and NIP have woken up perhaps a little bit too late as Freiburg gets himself the next. Fetish goes down, and it'll be AZ with not much health, dispatched of by Forest for his hat-trick frag, and that's a little more like it, NIP. Shame it's far too little too late. Forest at 14 frags, a 5-frag spread down to the next man. And that probably sums it up. Players like Getrak have been very quiet.
I think they've been relying on individual performances to win these rounds. I think especially as the only rounds we saw them win was when Getrak would get the opening frag on an AWP and they kind of opened the round up for them. Didn't seem like any real team players being employed. They had one strategy onto B, and I think they had a couple of specs for A as well, but they kind of looked pretty lost, and they were kind of just relying on people to kind of go big and get a couple of frags for them to win rounds. I think that's why we're seeing the scoreboard looking so empty for them. But here we go. We can see an almost forced buy from Dignitas here. I think you can see Fetish yet again just opting to use a pistol. He seems to be doing that a lot with his team. He doesn't seem to mind to be having no rifle in hand.
It'll be Zipnix to toss out the first nade. Exist is going to see action here as he fires off, and Getrak goes down at the hands of Device. Zipnix is going to claim the life of Exist, and with Forest, the last rock of defense over on that A site, he will get two before going down at the hands of AZ. It's a 3-on-2 to save the map for NIP as the bomb goes down, and Freiburg and Fifflower know that they're going to have to deliver something monumental to turn this around, as that Fifflower will be the first man to go for the frags. Gets dropped by Dupree. Freiburg pushes in 1-on-3, now 1-on-2, with one player completely concealed. You don't fancy his chances, but what a hit that was onto Device. The bomb beginning to tick louder and louder.
There it is.
And Dupree will finish it off. For Dignitas, that was boringly brilliant.
Yeah, a lackluster game for Nip there, but I think we called this quite early on. It's not a map they wanted to play.